interesting session on the security and geopolitics, continue in my provocative mode and throw out some questions for, I hope, the panelists will pick up on. First of all, what does Montenegro bring to NATO now? How will NATO membership endorse Montenegro's security? Whose aggression is Montenegro most worried about, potential aggression? Is Montenegro worried about increasing talk about a greater Albania that we've heard from Albanian leaders in the region? Are people worried about the divisions in Montenegrin society over NATO? And should there have been a referendum on membership? What about relations with Russia? Is this something that Montenegro just has to live with, Russia's dissatisfaction? Or are there things to be done to put them on an even keel? And finally, what about relations with neighboring Serbia after Vucic? So those are the sort of questions I hope our panelists will address. And with that, without further ado, I would like to invite Mr. Predrag Bošković, the Minister of Defense, to come and address us.
First of all, good morning to all of you, and it's a great pleasure and privilege to be today here. It's inspiring team, and especially in this moment, in our final phase on our accession to NATO, there is plenty of sub-teams that we could discuss today, but unfortunately, due to the limited time, I will just respond on some of the questions that Mr. Kekić said in his opening remarks. And first of all, I would like to underline and to point out that our accession to NATO is not something which is offensive and against of any other country, neither in a region, and especially not against Russia. It's our own interest to join to the club, to join with 28, someone would like to say, most developed nations in any sense, not just economically, but in terms of democracy, in terms of rule of law, in terms of fight against the organized crime, corruption, etc., etc. And that's something that goes through our past. We learned some lessons from the past. We were always on the right side of the history, but somehow we suffered a lot throughout the history and didn't have, as we would like to say, the fair share after the big crisis throughout the history. So now we would like to join to the club and to prevail our independence, to prevail our sustainability, to prevail our security, and to bring the long-lasting security and stability to the whole region, not to just to Montenegro. And we will be the biggest advocate to all the future members of NATO, because we really do think that the future of the whole Western Balkan is in NATO. And we would like to encourage all the nations in the Western Balkan to have a courage to make very difficult decisions and to finally make a U-turn from east to the west. And as I said, I'm pretty sure that the whole Balkan in NATO would bring long-lasting stability, and believe it or not, there is no single adult generation in Montenegro or in the whole Balkan region who doesn't remember at least one war in a region. So this is literally the most important reason why we are so desperate about joining to NATO, and why we think that whole Western Balkans should join the NATO? That's one question. The second question, I think with this answer I can respond to many of those questions what Mr. Kekić said in his opening remarks. I'm pretty sure then when whole Balkan would be in NATO, then we would not talk anymore about Great Albania, Great Serbia, Great Croatia, Great Montenegro, or whatever. Then I think all this issue would be solved with only one decision by the political elite in all the countries. And regarding the Russia, I must say that, as I said at the beginning, this is not, our accession to NATO is definitely not against Russia. We cannot understand why they are so furious about this decision. And especially we cannot understand and definitely not justify their behavior regarding the terrorist coup, regarding the assassination of the ex-prime minister, attempt of the assassination, fortunately. And this is somehow that history will probably try to explain in 20 or 30 years why they did this and why they are doing this, because their interference into the Montenegro domestic policy and not just the policy in daily life is on a daily basis, and it didn't stop with the elections on 16th of October. It's continuation of the process, and it's happening even now, even today, on completely different levels. For some of those, we for sure doesn't have proofs that Russia is behind, but everything else says that they are behind. So we will see what will happen in future months. Maybe we will have somehow revitalization of our relationship with Russia. They are on the lowest level after the 1953, I think. And but still, I'm pretty sure that we will be again on the right side of the history, and that our decision to join the NATO and to join the Euro-Atlantic integration as a first stepping stone on our Euro integration, and this is somehow that it's on the best interest not just of Montenegro population in Montenegro, but I'm pretty sure it's in the best interest of the Western Balkan, European Union, and a global peace and stability. Due to the fact that we are a very small country, but with our accession, I'm pretty sure that whole Mediterranean area will be much more in one circle and much more stable, without, let's say, some challenges that are still present in a region very close to the Mediterranean or on the Western Balkans. For a beginning, in 7 minutes, I think more than enough.
Thank you very much.